The broader U.S. economy remains resilient despite some volatility. That assurance coming from the White House amid fears the world's largest economy is in recessionary freefall. White House spokesperson Karine Jean-Pierre said the economic team is constantly monitoring the situation and is focused on bringing down the cost of commodities.
What we have seen recently is consumers remain resilient and business investment remains strong. Unemployment, while up from 50-year lows, is still low at 4.3%, and that's important. You think about inflation, it's down by 2.5%, and the stock market is up more than 35% under this administration. And so what we're going to focus on, we're going to focus on the middle class.
A bill seeking to impose a 12% value-added tax on foreign digital services expected to be signed soon by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The country's finance chief says more taxes could also be approved this year. Jackie Pascual with the full story.
Finance Secretary Ralph Recto says the president is expected to sign into law the value-added tax on digital services, which was recently approved by the bicameral committee. The bill imposes a 12% VAT on foreign digital service providers, including streaming apps, online shopping sites, and other platforms selling services in the Philippines.
Netflix, yan ba nagbabayad ng VAT sa Pilipinas? Yung income ng YouTube, dapat.
Kasama yan sa batas?
Kasama yan.
Okay.
Kung lahat nagbabayad ng VAT, ba't sila hindi?
About 20 billion pesos per year is the expected revenue from the new policy if it becomes a law. Online sellers are also now subjected to withholding tax after the Bureau of Internal Revenue strictly enforced a policy mandating e-marketplaces to impose a 1% withholding tax on half of the gross remittances of merchants.
Unfair naman kung halimbawa a brick and mortar store nagbabayad ng buwis tapos sila wala. Tama? Okay, so palagay ko dapat magbayad ng buwis. Basta kumikita ka.
Aside from this, at least 3 new tax laws or amendments are also expected to be approved this year.
Mining tax, single use. VAT on digital, tapos na yan. Pirmado na lang ng pipirma na lang ng Pangulo yan. At yung PIFITA, palagay ko, at saka yung create more. Yun, mga papasayan sa taong ito.
But with the new taxes set to be imposed, will it turn off foreign players? Secretary Recto doesn't think so.
Palagay ko, hindi magpo-pull out dito yan dahil ang Facebook ay 80 million ang Pilipino na sa Facebook. So malaking market tayo para sa Facebook.
Government needs to collect more revenues this year with a proposed budget for 2025 higher than this year's by over 10%. Recto, though, is confident, saying total revenues mid-year already grew by 15.6% to 2.15 trillion pesos, which is already half of the full-year target. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Finance Department inks a financing agreement with the Export-Import Bank of Korea for infrastructure projects nationwide. Finance Secretary Recto and KEXIM Chair and President Yoon Hee-sung signed the deal Wednesday. Among the infrastructure projects is the new Dumaguete City Airport, which will aim to accommodate up to 2.5 million passengers annually. KEXIM will support some 13 billion pesos of the 17 billion per project cost. Other projects covered by the deal include bridges connecting Panay, Guimaras, and Negros Islands, as well as 2 new road projects in the province of Cebu. The agreement also includes a $3 billion economic development promotion facility, which will serve as an additional financial bridge for government's Build Better More program. Social media platform X sues a global advertising alliance and several major companies, accusing them of conspiring to boycott the site and causing it to lose revenue. The lawsuit alleged advertisers, acting through an initiative called Global Alliance for Responsible Media, collectively withheld billions of dollars in advertising revenue from X. Ad revenue at X, previously known as Twitter, slumped for months after Elon Musk bought the company in 2022. Some advertisers have been wary of ad spending under Musk amid worries their brands would appear next to harmful content that the platform's previous owners had removed.